This video is supported in part by Retro Days, a place for nostalgia nerds to gather, share memories, chat, and engage. Go to RetroDays.com or check their YouTube channel linked below.
Back in the late 70s, if you wanted to simulate World War I air combat, this was pretty much the best you could get.
Oh, I was behind you! How is that even physically possible?
It takes real skill.
And although it was a blast to play, as you just saw, it wasn't what anybody would call a real simulation. Well, that changed in 1980, and I'll show you that with some imagination and these books, you could feel like you were in the cockpit of a World War I fighter having a dogfight over southern France. Don't you know that you're a grown up? No games, no puns. Not allowed if you're a grown up. Hello, welcome to Gen X Grown Up. My name is Mo, and I am a Gen X Grown Up. Oh, before we start, if you enjoy this video, or really any of the videos on our channel, we'd really appreciate it if you took a second and press the subscribe button that should be on the screen right about now. Back in 1980, a company called Nova came up with a game called Ace of Aces. It was the ultimate choose-your-own-adventure game because you and a friend got to fly World War I airplanes and dogfight until you either shot your friend out of the sky or drove them off with their tail between their legs. Now, I was able to get my hands on the deluxe edition that came out a few years later, but you could still play the basic original game with it. So how this works is that each book represents the cockpit view of two airplanes looking at each other. So if you look at this example, the German pilot is looking through his right wing at the Allied plane, while the Allied pilot is looking just behind his right wing at the German plane. I'm going to explain how the game works, and if you get confused, please don't worry. I have a small demo later in the video with some visual aids I think will hopefully help clear everything up. Each player gets a book and opens it to page 170, which is the standard start screen. Across the bottom of each page are maneuvers you can do for the next move. The top number shows how far the move would take you. The row below shows the general direction of that move, which we'll come back to later. Then the maneuver itself with a letter and number below it. Each player decides what maneuver they want to do. So let's say that the Allied plane decides that he wants to do a turn to the left, and the German pilot chooses to do a slow, sharp turn to the right. Each player makes a note of the letter and tells the opponent the number below what they selected. So the Allied player remembers or writes down someplace, I-130, and the person playing the German plane notes F-106. The next step is that each player goes to the page number that their opponent gave them and looks for the letter of the move they selected, ignoring the picture altogether. So the Allied player looks on page 106 for the letter I, and the German player looks on page 130 for the letter F. Both players now turn to the page number that is just below the letter, and if all goes right, they will both turn magically to the same page, which in this case is page 94, which shows the end result of both of those moves. And then you just go on to the next move, and the goal is to line up your plane so that you can get a shot off. Okay, so now that I kind of explained the basics, here's a more visual example that I think will help clarify this. So both players are starting back on page 170, and the planes are in the following positions, more or less. The German pilot decides to do a slip move to the right, which is an 064, and the Allied pilot decides to do a right turn, which gives him a P148. After following the instructions I went through before, it gives them both page 86, which should put them into something like this. And when you look on page 86, boom, there it is. So you'll notice that there is a small T on the Allied position and a capital T on the German page. This means that the German player is now tailing the Allied player. This means the Allied player must tell the German player which of the three directions they are choosing for the next move. For this example only, let's assume the Allied pilot is going to do something cute and do a move forward to hopefully have the German plane overshoot him or something like that, which is an L117. So because he is now tailed, he tells the other player that he will be doing a straight move, which could be any of these moves on their sheet. The German player, not fooled and with this new information, decides to do another slip to the right, which is an 02. Both players now share the page numbers, look up the letter code for what they chose, and it brings both players to page 96. Things don't look good for the Allied plane, and sure enough, the Allied player is now being shot at and may end in a fiery death. Okay, so that gives you a basic idea of the game. But let me tell you, they have advanced rules that can add as much complexity as you like. Such as depending on where you're damaged or what your previous maneuver was, that may determine what your next move can be. Like you can't do a sharp left turn after a sharp right turn. They even have these cards that will show you which moves can be done when to replicate the different unique capabilities of different airplanes of the time. Let me tell you, I think this thing is nothing short of genius. And I can't tell you the hours I spent on the phone with my friend playing this, which you can do because we both had a set of the books. You can even do like a 2-on-1 dogfight as long as one person keeps track of 2 pages. And I can't tell you what impressed me more, the ingenuity of this game or just how much fun it was to play. I hope you enjoyed this video, and if you played this or something similar, please let me know. And thanks for watching. All right, take care.
Gen X Grown Up is dedicated to bringing you new Generation X-inspired videos every week. Here are a couple more you can watch right now, but for even more, subscribe and enable those notifications. And if you love what we do, we invite you to support us over on Patreon. And of course, your feedback in the comments and a quick thumbs up are always appreciated.